I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. We're going to do my very best original potato soup today. We'll start by preparing our vegetables. Right here, I have chopped up three potatoes. This is just an example of the size that I used. I have three of them chopped up coarsely. I would say that they are maybe 1/2 to 3/4 of an inch on a side. They don't have to be symmetric or perfectly shaped. Just get them chopped up. And I have them standing in water because if I were going to let them stand for a while without water, they would turn brown. Here I have one carrot. That's all I needed here. And I've chopped it up a little finer. I would say maybe it is 1/4 to 1/2 inch on a side. And these dimensions are not extremely important, but you do need to separate these vegetables into pieces instead of putting them whole into a pot. The third vegetable is onion, and I've just taken one medium to large sized onion, and I've used the kitchen chopper here, electric. That was quicker and fewer tears to do, so we have that ready. Now what I need to do is drain these. So I have a pot here with a colander, and I'm gonna set it in the sink and then just bring over the potatoes. Remember, three whole potatoes chopped up, and get rid of that water. And then the carrots, one carrot chopped up a little more finely. Get rid of that water. And then, when I get rid of this water down the sink, we'll beat it and use this as a base in order to hold that colander. Now I have my onion still to add. So I'll just use a spatula. And this onion is sort of minced. It's pretty fine. You don't want big pieces of onion in your potato soup. So it's going to look something like that. And that's good enough, I think. Now what we're going to do with these vegetables is go over to the stove and get them cooking. You need some margarine, and what I have over here is 1 stick of margarine, which has been melted in a deep skillet. So I'm going to put my vegetables in here, and then I'm gonna salt them. I don't put pepper on them, and that's just mainly because I don't like the look of pepper in a white soup. Expect some popping, and get all of those vegetables into your skillet. There might be a little extra water that went in there. That's not a problem, it will cook down. I'm gonna stir this around because I want the flavors to be blended throughout, not just in one spot for the onions. And you know, the carrots are there as a very subtle hint of flavor, but probably as much for that little tiny bit of color. And as this cooks down, you'll see how it sort of blends in and makes it look just a little bit richer. So I'll turn that down because I was afraid of all the popping. I'm gonna turn it back up so that I can hear this sizzling nicely. Then I'll be using the lid to cover it, and it's just a waiting game at that point. I want to come and stir it occasionally, and it may start sticking to the bottom. That's fine. It may get a little brown. That's fine. It just gives a little more flavor to it. So don't worry about any of those things. We just want these nice and soft so that they can be mashed up, and then we'll finish up our soup. So you can begin to hear these sizzle. Turn that up a bit to get you started on this. Simple as can be. It's a very easy recipe, and the chopping is so any way you want to do it. It's not special that I have chosen these sizes. These are just my preferences. But get it cooking. Now I've got it on pretty high heat, just so you can see it begin to cook. cover it with the lid, and the lid doesn't have to fit perfectly. It may go way down in there. This one is pretty close to the top. But that just holds in the steam and cooks them better, and it also prevents popping that might come out here. Now, I will be turning that down and letting it just sizzle along, and I'll check it every once in a while to stir it, and I may have done some mashing when I come back to see you next. I'm back making my potato soup, and you can see that the potatoes, the carrots, and the onions are completely cooked, and they have been mashed. They've been stirred around a few times, just occasionally, and then as they got near to done, I took the potato masher and mashed them until they are pretty much like mashed potatoes, but they're lumpy. Excuse me. All that noise trying to get off all the potatoes. So we turn that off, and believe me, I did not forget the salt. I did put in probably 1 teaspoon, but you can just salt it to your taste, and you can taste of it at the end to see if it's salty enough. If it's not, put a little more salt in it. So what we're going to do at this point is add milk. And this is skim milk, and I've poured out 2 cups here. I am just going by what I think might work because I never really measure anything, and I'm trying to give you exact measurements. So you just stir this around. And obviously that's not enough. That was about 1 cup. It's going to take 2 cups easily. And if that's not enough, I have some more milk setting over there. Stir this around. And you can pretty much tell when it's the texture that you would enjoy eating. And we get all of that lumpy potato mix combined with the milk. And that's pretty much it. This is very hot still. If you want it heated back up, heat it to boiling and then turn it off. You don't want to keep cooking it after this step. So what you can do is put this in a nice soup tureen, or you can just use a ladle and put it straight to a dish. I like to garnish it with parsley, and you can do that in the dish, or you can do it for your whole pot here. So just some cleaned, fresh, snipped parsley along the top after it's all cooked. And that gives it a nice, mild flavor, and the color is beautiful. And you'll hope that you'll get a little bit of that in yours. And as it continues to be served, it will get stirred around toward the bottom. But at this point, it just remains on the top. And that looks really nice. So I'm going to move my serving dish and use a ladle of any type you like. Probably a fancier one would be nice here. But just ladle that nice potato soup into your serving dish. And it's ready to go. So there is my very original potato soup. Now I have made some corn muffins to go with this. I started them while the potatoes were on the stove, so I don't know how they're coming along. Let's just take a look. Looks like they might be done. So what I'm going to do is turn off the oven and get them out and place one in a serving dish so I can have it with my soup. Remember, if you don't know how to do these, go to my Betty's Very Southern corn sticks and or corn bread. I decided to put them in a muffin tin this time. So you can use any of those options. And then let's just try to get one of these out. This one looks nice. You see how nice that is on the bottom? Place that over on your plate. These are scalding hot. Put a little butter there. And if your bowl will fit there, you can stack that alongside. And there you have a nice meal. It's gonna spill. There's your meal.